woman becomes trapped inside her home as water rushes in. The water. An entire house, a camper, a truck. Tonight, it is all underwater on the Crow Wing River. Good evening, everyone. I'm Chris O'Connell.
I'm Leah McLean. Now, take a look at these areas. These are areas across the state forecasted to be most at risk for flooding right now. But it's what was unpredictable, an ice jam that forced the Crow River to rise 6 feet in 2 hours in the town of Motley. Jennifer Griswold is there live tonight with the rescue. Jennifer.
Live in Motley, Jennifer Griswold, 5 Eyewitness News.
And flood conditions are changing rapidly. In just the last 15 minutes, we have a new warning right here in St. Paul.
That's right. Let's get right over to meteorologist Chicago Windler. She's in the Weather Center with the latest. Chicago.
More than 1,000 students helped sandbag homes around Fargo-Moorhead today, but there is real concern tonight. There aren't enough volunteers showing up to be ready in time. The National Weather Service now says the Red River will crest a day later than the original forecast, hitting 20 feet above flood stage early Sunday. Because of the widespread flooding, disaster teams will move into place first thing in the morning. 280 National Guard soldiers will be on the ground in Moorhead, mainly patrolling dikes and controlling traffic. State Patrol will also have a helicopter and 30 troopers to help, along with airboats from the DNR for any rescue missions. Now, southwest of the Twin Cities, people are piling sandbags and gravel to protect homes from this. Sheds and roads are underwater along Buffalo Creek in Brownton. And we found even with people with flood insurance may not be as protected as you might think. Still ahead, see what needs to move to higher ground to be covered.
I'm in St. Paul, Mark Albert, 5 Eyewitness News.
Denny Hecker could soon go to jail, but it has nothing to do with his federal fraud case. According to court filings, Hecker is thousands of dollars behind in alimony to his second wife, who he divorced in 1983. Hecker has until the end of the month to explain to a judge why he hasn't paid. If the judge doesn't accept the explanation, Hecker could go to jail for 90 days.
A man who called 911.
Minnesota Timberwolves star Al Jefferson had a blood alcohol level of 0.12 when he was arrested last month. State Patrol just got back that blood test. Troopers pulled Jefferson over in Minneapolis around 1 a.m. on February 28th for speeding and changing lanes without signaling. Jefferson apologized and was suspended for 2 games. He's set in court next month.
Pay cuts could be coming.
Airline passengers say they were rationing potato chips. We'll take you inside the plane passengers were stuck inside and show you how they finally got home.